Let's talk about the Pittsburgh Pirates right now with Larry Broadway, the director of minor league operations. Larry, it's Brian Kenny. Welcome to MLB Now.
Hey, Brian, appreciate it.
Larry, start off, we're so impressed with your holistic approach with analytics, with scouting, with just plain common sense. Give us something that you think your club does that's working, that's getting good players to the major leagues. What are you doing in your approach?
Well, I think you hit it on the head. The holistic approach it goes beyond the technical tackle aspects of the game. We try to develop the whole player, the whole man, from every angle, and try to maximize every player's ability the best we can.
Larry Outlider here, and I'm curious of what Brian just said. This is an organization that can't rely on just signing big free agents, and it is very important how you scout and you player develop, and you've done an excellent job. But I'm curious, when I look at the names that the Pirates have developed, that there was their homegrown talent, not trades, and I look at the pitching staff. One, you got Tyler Glasnow as your number one prospect. I know he was in high A. How is Jameson Taillon? You have Gerrit Cole as the front end guy, but is there something that's moving along that maybe pitching is becoming a priority in the way in which that you develop the pitchers? Because prior to Gerrit Cole, you have to go back to Paul Mahalam, who was your first rounder in 2003, for a legitimate starter in the Pirates rotation that was signed and developed by you guys.
Yeah, I think it took a while as the the changeover happened with this regime in 2008. New scouting philosophy, new development philosophy. That came in with Neil Huntington and Kyle Stark and Greg Smith on the player development and scouting side. They committed to some things. We went with a lot of prep players, a lot of prep pitchers that just have kind of started to take time to get to that level. So not necessarily on the player development side. The scouting side has done a great job of committing to a set of values that we're looking for. And then as they come into the system, we try to get them rolling and do the best we can to get them to be the best they can be.
Larry, Mike Lowell here. In 2009, the Pirates built a new facility in the Dominican Republic. And speaking of developing guys, as I look down, three of your top 13 prospects are Dominican. When you look at Gregory Polanco, Alan Hansen, Willie Garcia, and as in the 40-man roster, 9 out of the 40 guys are of Dominican descent. Was this a conscious effort to say, hey, we got to tap into the Latin American market to develop those guys, and it has to be not only through the draft, but in the international signings?
There's no question. We've got to take every advantage that we can. And, we've got a tremendous facility down there. Rene Gallo, our director of Latin American scouting, has done a tremendous job of just of getting the guys in, of getting athletes in, of getting ball players in. And our guys at the academy work tirelessly. Our staff works like crazy. Mayu Fielding, even our education coordinator, has these guys taking classes, learning English. Just really trying to get them prepared to come over here to the States and to move up the ladder. And as you see, we've got a number of guys, as you mentioned, on the 40-man, even in our lower ranks that are moving up and are preparing to make an impact in Pittsburgh at some point.
Larry, it's John Hine, longtime Pittsburgh Pirate fan. Thanks for the last 2 years after the previous two decades.
But
here's my question. That outfield, Marte, McCutchen, Polanco, young, locked. But you've got prospects like Josh Bell, Austin Meadows, outfielders. Where do they go? I know you shifted Bell to first base, and I think the Pirates are a little weak on the corners in the minor leagues. Is that what you do? Do you shift the catcher, a different position player, because you've got that youth in the outfield?
Yeah, I think as you look, Bell was, coming up, that outfield's pretty strong. As you mentioned, you try to find a way to get guys able defensively to play some different positions so that when an opportunity arises in the big league and their bat's ready, if they're a bat-first guy, that we can get them in a different position rather than just waiting for their one specific spot to open up. We've done that with Bell. We've done that with Alan Hansen. Kind of give him an opportunity to play some second base, so that gives him a little more versatility up the middle of the diamond. But the other guys, that when they're in A ball, you don't worry about that. We're gonna help develop them in their best possible position to be the best offensive and defensive players they can. As they get to the upper levels, if we've got to make a decision on expanding their versatility defensively, just so they'll fit with the current makeup of a club, given a need, then we do that then.
And Larry, John Hine again, because I'm a Pirate fan, let me ask a follow-up question.
Sure.
Nice. What's going on up the middle with Kong now in there? I know Walker's in a walk year and Mercer, and there's a lot of different talk about what's going to happen with this Korean shortstop. And how do you measure the potential of someone who played over in Korea?
Well, I think, we've had scouts over there that have liked him. Obviously, people have seen over here World Baseball Classic. you know, we've gotten our bench has gotten deeper now, and whether whoever goes to the bench goes to the bench, our main goal is getting him over here, getting him transitioned into being a major league player into this season, this environment, into this country. You know, there's a lot of things that are going to have to take place for him to transition over here successfully. So we're just excited to get the player to come in and to get to know him and see what he can do and see how he matches up with the rest of the guys and how he fits in the clubhouse and in the lineup.
Larry, would you be willing to stay on and do the MLB Now after show with John Hine? Could you stay on for another hour or so?
Whatever you want, guys. I'm here ready.
He's ready to go with you. Larry, hey, congratulations on the success. Again, we're watching and paying attention. You guys are doing great work there, and best of luck this year.
I appreciate it, guys. It's been fun. Thanks for having me.